How many times have you heard the phrase petroleum-based fertilizer? I've heard it so many times that I've used the phrase myself without even questioning it, just assuming it was correct. But are synthetic fertilizers really petroleum-based? Are they actually made from petrochemicals? A fertilizer buying guide from National Geographic says synthetic fertilizers are commonly derived from petroleum. It also claims that a typical 40-pound bag of fertilizer contains the equivalent of 2.5 gallons of gasoline. An ad for an organic gardening product goes even further and compares the use of conventional fertilizer to pouring oil directly on the soil. It was this over-the-top comparison that really raised a red flag for me and prompted me to dig into this issue more deeply. Before going further, I want to clarify that my intention here is not to minimize the downside of synthetic fertilizers. There are many. I also don't intend to minimize the fact that our food system is heavily dependent on fossil fuels. Rather, I simply want to ensure that my use and advocacy of organic practices is based on facts. Relying on half-truths and myths to promote organic gardening will only hurt the cause in the long run. So to answer the question, are synthetic fertilizers really made from petroleum? Let's take a look at how the N, P, and K in fertilizers are derived and see if any of them come from petroleum. The nitrogen in synthetic fertilizer is harnessed from the atmosphere using the Haber-Bosch process, which is a man-made nitrogen-fixing process. It takes atmospheric nitrogen gas, which is not available to plants, and turns it into a plant-available form through a reaction with hydrogen gas. The resulting plant-available form is ammonia, or NH3. Ammonia is then used to produce a variety of fertilizers. So are the nitrogen or hydrogen in NH3 derived from petroleum? The nitrogen is harnessed from the atmosphere, which is 78% nitrogen. And hydrogen usually comes from methane, which is derived from natural gas. Neither comes from petroleum. So it's not accurate to say that synthetic nitrogen fertilizers are made from petroleum. It is true, however, that the hydrogen in NH3 is usually derived from another fossil fuel, natural gas. However, I definitely not take it a step further and compare the use of synthetic nitrogen fertilizer to pouring liquefied natural gas onto my garden soil. It's really not the same thing. Though the hydrogen is derived from natural gas, the resulting ammonia, or NH3, is the same as if the hydrogen had been derived from another source, like the electrolysis of water. Okay, let's move on to phosphorus. The phosphorus in most conventional fertilizers comes from mined rock phosphate, which is the same source used by many organic fertilizers. However, to make the phosphorus plant available, the rock phosphate is reacted with chemicals like ammonia to produce fertilizers like monoammonium and diammonium phosphate. These fertilizers bring together the nitrogen from the Haber-Bosch process with the phosphorus from the rock phosphate. So the phosphorus in conventional fertilizers does not come from petroleum. It comes from rock phosphate. So that leaves us with potassium. Is it derived from petroleum? No, it isn't. The potassium in synthetic fertilizers comes from mined salts that were left behind after the drying of ancient oceans. So the N, P, and K in synthetic fertilizers don't come from petroleum. The nitrogen comes from the air, the phosphorus comes from rock phosphate, and the potassium comes from the remains of ancient oceans. However, the hydrogen in ammonia produced by the Haber-Bosch process does come from another fossil fuel, natural gas. As I mentioned earlier, my intention here is not to defend synthetic fertilizers or minimize the extent to which our food system is dependent on fossil fuels. Instead, I'm just trying to do my best to separate fact from fiction so that when I advocate for organic practices, I know I'm standing on solid ground. In the upcoming weeks, I hope to release another video in which I talk about why I prefer organic practices over synthetic fertilizers. Well, that's all for now. Thank you very much for watching. And until next time, remember, you can change the world 1 yard at a time.